Welcome to Lovely Nail and Beauty. Please subscribe to my channel, click on the notification bell, and also don't forget to click on the like button if you like the video. Thank you. Hi guys, welcome to Lovely Nail and Beauty. Today I'm gonna do a new project. I'm gonna teach you how to apply the Polygel on nail. So that will be my first time to doing that. First of all, I'm gonna show you what I'm gonna use. I'm gonna use my oil cuticle. I'm gonna put that on the side. And I'm gonna use my nail mold for extension. So it will have a plastic form for the nail. And I'm gonna use my poly nail extension gel. I choose the nude color. That's what I'm gonna use. And now I have the top base and the base gel nail polish. That's what I'm gonna use. And also right there I have a special brush that have one side, you can see there is the brush, and the other side there is a tail trimmer. So I'm gonna use that too for my project. And right there I have my small glass with cover that I'm gonna use, and I have my brush over there. And also I'm gonna use my clipper with a straight end. I like to use it. And I have two files, the 180 and the 240, to file my nail. So I'm gonna put that on the side. And also if you want, you can use the regular transparent top coat if you want. So right there I have the jelly cleaner, and I have my cotton over there. So now I'm gonna start my project. So the first thing that I should start with, right there you have already my nail mold for extension. Always try to choose the one that fits your nail. It's very important. So you should not choose a small one. So right there I'm gonna pour my slip solution for the poly gel. So I'm gonna add a little bit inside. We don't need too much for that. I'm gonna close it. I'm gonna put it on the side, and I will need my brush. There we go. So I'm gonna start with those two. It's not that so hard to do. So here you have the brush, and here you have the trimmer, and we're gonna see how to use it also. So I'm gonna put it on the side. So the first step that I'm gonna do, I'm gonna use the base coat poly gel, the base coat nail polish. So I'm gonna apply that on my fingernail. So that's the first step. And for the poly gel, you don't need any pH bond. It does not come with. So you just need to clean your nail, file the surface of your nail with a soft file, and then you apply the base coat. It's come with, it's a set. And there is different brand that you can use. So I'm applying that. And now I'm gonna use my UV light. So that's the beginning of the project. So I'm gonna set it up for a couple of seconds. I always like to put 90 seconds, but most of the time it's dry before the 90 seconds. So you can also check before the time to make sure that it's dry. So I'm gonna leave it for a couple of seconds. And I think I'm gonna check now to see. Yeah, it's good. So I'm gonna turn off my UV light. There we go. So now I'm gonna start my poly gel nail. So here I have my glass, my brush, and there we go. I have my poly nail extension gel, and I choose the nude color. I like that color. It looks so natural. That's the color I'm gonna show you. So now I'm gonna start. So I'm gonna take first my plastic nail mold extension. So there we go. So most of the time people use the trimmer, but I don't. I just use the tube. That's just me. I decide to do it like that. So you need to put a good quantity. It depends on the length that you want for your nail. And now you have to dip your brush in the slip solution, and gently you have to spray the poly gel on your nail mold. So you have to make sure that the poly gel go on the side too, and you know, each time that you feel like the brush starts to become sticky, you can dip it back again in the slip solution. So that will be my first time to doing that video. I hope that the result is gonna be good. We're gonna see. So I never did that before. So, and it's funny because it's very sticky. So now I'm gonna turn back and I'm gonna put it on my fingernail. I adjust it. And sometimes people are using clipper, but I don't like because I feel like the pressure is too strong. And now I'm gonna dip again in the slip solution, take off all the extra polygel that came on my skin. And now I like also to put a light pressure on the nail on the table. I use the table instead of the clipper and it's worked for me. So I just want to make sure that under my nail, it came nice too, because it's not like the acrylic nail. The acrylic nail, it's easy because it dries so quick. So now I'm gonna use my UV light just for maybe 15 seconds. So I'm gonna do that for each fingernail because the poly gel is so different from the acrylic. It does not get hard. The only way for the poly gel to get hard, you have to use the UV light. So it's always safe to do each finger, put it for a couple of seconds in the UV light before keep going. So now I'm gonna do the second nail. As you can see, I make sure that my nail mold extension fit the size of my real nail. And I'm gonna add again my poly gel, extension gel. I'm gonna turn because I am a left hand. So I'm gonna use my brush again, dip it on the slip solution for the poly gel. So it's funny to do. I really like it, and it's very easy to do compared to the set of acrylic nail, because when you do the acrylic nail, you need to have some skill to be precise. So now I'm gonna fix again my poly gel. There we go. So I just apply a light pressure, and now I'm gonna clean all the extra poly gel that you can see between my skin and my nail. So, but you have to be careful because it never gets hard. And now I'm gonna clean again. Again, I'm gonna use the table as my clipper, but I apply a light pressure. So I'm gonna make sure that I fix my poly gel under my nail because I want to have a natural look. And I'm gonna use again my UV. I make a mess. I split my slip solution for the poly gel. So I'm gonna add a little bit more inside. Things happen. So I'm gonna let it dry for a couple of seconds. So it's okay. So I'm doing that because, like I told you, the poly gel never get hard. The only way to get hard, you have to put it on the UV light. So I'm doing each one finger after the other one, because if you put all your set on all your finger, it will be easy for you to have an accident and you have to start all over. So it just save when you finish one fingernail, you put it on the UV light for a couple of seconds and you take off. At least it gets harder and you can still do the other fingernail. So right now, as you can see, I didn't take off yet my plastic nail mold for extension. So I'm gonna do that at the end. Again, I fix my poly gel. Okay, I'm gonna take off again the extra poly gel between my skin and the nail. And it's nice because it's never dry. It does not dry. So, and when I adjust my poly gel, I make sure that I don't have any bubble. And again, I also do the back. You can see there is a bump under my nail. So I make sure that under my nail, the surface looks so good. Look like the natural nail. That's what I'm doing right now. Okay, that look nice. And you know, each time, I mean, I feel it's very safe to do it like that. It's work for me because I don't want to have to set up all my fingernail and unfortunately have some accident. So I can keep going now. So those three fingernails are kind of dry already. So the step is the same. And again, you can use the tube like I do, or you can also use the nail trimmer that can stick to the brush. You can use that too, but I just prefer to use the tube. I don't want to use that. That's just me. This polygel is very sticky. And also I like to use gloves because it's very sticky. So it's fun to do. And the plastic nail mold make it easy because it make already the shape of the nail that you want. So you don't have a lot of hard work filing them because the shape is there already compared to the acrylic nail. The acrylic nail take more time and you need to be quick, precise because it dries so quick. But with this one is not the case. I think it's more easy to do than the acrylic nail. That's my opinion. So, okay, that's the fourth one. And now I'm gonna brush the back of my nail and I apply the table. When I put my fingernail on the table, I just put a light pressure because if I press too hard, all the polygel is gonna be out. So I'm gonna put back again in my UV light. And each time that I put back my one fingernail on the UV light, I use that to put all the other fingernail inside so that I wanna make sure that it's drying properly. Okay, I think it's ready. So now finally we're gonna do the last one, and always make sure that the plastic nail mold fit your nail. You should not choose a small size or a big size than the size of your nail, otherwise it's gonna be a mess. And maybe in the future I'm gonna do a video about the do and don't of the polygel technique. So that's my first video. We're gonna see. So I'm applying my polygel over there, and it's so nice because you can fix whatever polygel that go on the side with the slip solution. It's very easy, and that's what I'm doing. I mean, you can also use the clipper, but I just decide to do not use it. I think the pressure on the nail is too much with the clipper. So I just want to apply a light pressure. Okay, so I clean the side, and now I'm gonna fix again my nail, and I'm gonna clean under my fingernail, make sure that it have a nice curve inside, natural one. And when I'm done with this one, I'm gonna put back my fingernail on the UV light again for a couple of seconds. It does not take too much in the UV light, and it's so amazing. So I'm a little bit nervous. I hope that the result will be good. We're gonna see. So I'm gonna put my hands back in the UV light, and I'm gonna wait for a couple of seconds to see how things is gonna come out. I hope it's gonna be okay, but so far so good. I like it. It's a new experience and I'm happy to do it. So again, I'm gonna let it for a couple of minutes because I really want to make sure that all my polygel nail dry properly. So we're gonna see. I think it's done. So now I'm gonna turn off my machine. And now I'm gonna take off one by one the plastic nail mold for extension. And it's so easy to take off. You can hear the crack sound. It's very easy. And you can see I have the shape already. That's amazing. It's really easy for a beginner, or if you have a hard time to apply the acrylic, that's the best to use. Or if you want to go out, you don't have enough time, it's quick. So I'm going to take off the mold on this one again. I just put a small pressure. As you can see, the shape is there already. Now I'm going to use my clipper with straight end. And I really love it because to me, I always like to do the coffin shape. And this clipper really helped me. It helped me to shape my nail. And it make my file job so easy. That's why I like it. But again, you use whatever you want. You can see that first fingernail look already, the shape is right. So I really like to use it, I really do. It make my fan so easy, I really do. So that's just me, but you don't have to use the straight end clipper. You can use whatever works for you, but for me, that's what I like to use. And maybe for some of you, you're gonna use it too. So it's so easy with that, I like it. You can see my fingernail look kind of foul, but it's not foul yet. So this clipper really make my job easy. It really helped me to file without extra work, and that's why I like it. So as you can see, the shape is there already. That's so nice, I really love it. So I'm gonna fix this one again. I'm gonna create the coffin shape. That's what I wanna create. That looks so nice, I love it. But I didn't start to file yet. So as you can see, it look cute already. I didn't file yet, but I'm gonna file now. Okay, so now I'm gonna clean a little bit. Now I'm gonna file my nail. So this black file, I'm gonna use that just to shape again the form of my nail to have the coffin shape. And as you can see, when I try to fix the shape of my nail, it's so easy, because the clipper did already the big job. So I don't need to file too much, and that's so cute, I love it. So this black file is the 180, it's a rough file. It's used only for the shape of the nail, and later on I'm gonna use a soft file that I will apply on the surface of my nail. So I just try to make sure that the shape is right, but you can see it's much easier because I have the shape already with the clipper. So that looks cute. I really love it. I like the nude color. It looks so natural. Okay, so now I'm gonna use the soft file. I'm gonna file the surface, because between my skin and my nail, you will realize that there is some kind of polygel, extra polygel. So I just want to make sure that it's smooth, and I want to make sure that I have the C curve that I want. So I'm gonna do that for each of my fingernail, and I like really what I'm seeing, I really do. Wow, that's so nice. You can see the C curve, I like it. So now I'm gonna file my nail one after the other one. Again, that's my first time to doing that video. We're gonna see the end. But so far so good, I like what I'm seeing. So the video of today is to teach you how to apply the polygel on a real nail. So it's something new for me, and also I would like to let you know that you can go on Lovely Nail and Beauty on YouTube, and you know, you can check some artwork that I have done so far. You can send me a message, tell me what you think about my work. And you know, the critics are welcome too, because I need that to improve my video and to improve my work too. And also, I would like to thank my subscriber. I would like to thank my viewer, even those who does not subscribe. I would like to thank everybody for the time that they spend watching my video. I hope that each video teach you something to learn, because that's the purpose of my channel, learning. So, you know, and also I'd like to thank all the YouTubers who take their time to watch my video and send me message. I really do appreciate. So thank you so much, guys. You guys keep me going. So I'm almost done filing my nail. As you can see, the file is so easy, but when you file the acrylic nail, it takes more time. But this one is much easy, and the poly gel is not that so hard like the acrylic nail. There is a difference. It's hard, but it's less tough than the acrylic nail. So I keep filing my nail, but I like the color already. I'm filing that because I really want the top coat to stick on it. That's why I'm filing the surface of my nail. So I'm almost done, but so far so good. I really do love it. It looks classy, the color is nice. So now I'm gonna clean the dust with my brush, and it looks nice. I love it. But here you can see there is an extra polygel, so I can use my clipper too. I really love that clipper, so it's easy to take off the extra polygel, as you see. That's what I'm doing now. I really love that clipper. It's doing a lot of stuff. So I make sure that I have the right shape, and I'm gonna file just a little bit again. So you can see the shape is there. It looks so nice, and it's easy to apply, especially for beginner who does not know how to apply the acrylic. You can use the polygel. It's much easy. That looks so nice. I love it. So now I'm done. I'm done filing my nail, so it looks so nice. I love it. It's so beautiful. So now I'm gonna use the top coat. It's a gel polish that I'm using, the transparent one. So I'm gonna apply that on each of my fingernail. That's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna take my time for that. This color looks so classy. I love it. I really do. So again, we almost done. So I'm gonna apply that. After I finish to apply the top coat of the polygel, so of the nail polish, sorry, I'm gonna put my nail on the UV light. But so far so good. I like what I see. It looks cute to me. I'm very pleased with the result. I didn't expect that, so I'm so pleased with it. Looks nice, and my thumb finger, it's so wild in the end. That's why you have this impression to see my nail. So now I'm gonna use my UV light for a couple of seconds, and I'm gonna put my hands inside and just wait. I always set up at 90, but it dry most of the time before 90. Now I'm gonna check my nail. Wow, it looks so cute. Now I'm gonna use the gelish cleaner, the blue liquid. So I like to use it because it helped me to clean my hands and to take off all the sticky sensation that I can feel on my nail. So I really love it. That's what I always use in each of my video where I'm doing nail. I use that. I love it. As you can see, everything become bright, net, clean. That's why I love it. Take off the dust too. Wow, that's so beautiful. So now I'm gonna use my cuticle oil. I like to use it. So I'm gonna just put one drop in each fingernail. It's really good for your cuticle, that oil. It moisturizes. So now I'm gonna rub them. And we almost done with my project. So it's so beautiful. I can't believe it. I'm gonna clean again. Okay guys, so that's the way it look. It look amazing. I love it. I can believe it. Wow, the shape, everything, the color, it's so beautiful. So thank you so much to my subscriber, to my viewer, and even to those who does not subscribe my channel. I hope you learned something from my channel, from the video from today. And thank you so much to be with me, and I hope to see you next time. Bye. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, to click on the notification bell and on the like button. Thank you for watching.